South Miami is a mix of restaurants, workplaces, homes, parks, and shopping. But 20 years ago, almost none of this was here. South Miami looked abandoned. Now it's back. How'd they do it?
The hometown plan for the city of South Miami is a Main Street revitalization project that's been unfolding for about 20 years. South Miami continues to grow, and there's still a lot of work to do. But we now have a walkable, urban downtown. Our firm gets to work in a lot of places, but our office has long been located here. Through the years, we've learned a few lessons that apply to most Main Streets.
We're on Dorn Avenue. It used to look quite different. The sidewalks were only 5 feet wide, and the street looked much like a parking lot. The street had no name. It was just a number. Now it's called Dorn Avenue, named after one of the founding families of South Miami. The transformation of South Miami started here on this one block segment. It's perpendicular to Sunset Drive, visible from Miami's metro rail. The city removed its ban on outdoor dining. The sidewalks were widened, and the local Chamber of Commerce, Chamber South, sold personalized bricks and the benches and the trees to offset some of the costs. For a relatively small investment of $200,000 public dollars, the city showed that the efforts behind the hometown plan were well worth it. We were able to demonstrate how the rest of the downtown could be like, and it now serves the community like a town square.
Great places need great streets. Buildings create a continuous urban form, and awnings provide shelter. Narrow travel lanes, designed to accommodate cyclists and pedestrians, transform the street into a place. Awnings, umbrellas, and generous shade trees provide a comfortable place to sit or to walk. Brick is used instead of asphalt, and a coordinated palette of materials unifies the space.
We're on Sunset Drive. It didn't always look like this. This area used to have vacant storefronts and felt like a highway. Once Dorn Avenue proved that we could have a walkable urban place, Sunset Drive was given a street diet. It was transformed with reduced travel lanes, on-street parking, wider sidewalks, street trees, and clearly visible crosswalks. Then came a facelift for the buildings. Reduced parking requirements made possible projects that were illegal before. I designed these buildings. These have a door on the street, a storefront, a cozy plaza where there was once a historic plaza. New buildings on Sunset Drive are required to be a minimum of 2 stories in height. This height requirement helps to establish a sense of enclosure for pedestrians on the street.
Walkable environments are safe, comfortable, and interesting to the pedestrian. Shopfronts create interest, and Sunset Drive, Red Road, and Dorn Avenue are lined with a variety of shopfronts. Shopfronts are close to the street, there's generous window space. Lintels and sills, columns, transoms divide the space and give a sense of structure. Pedestrian signage and lighting. Awnings give shade and rain protection. Galleries can be better than awnings, but awnings will do.
I've lived in South Miami for 17 years. Now I'm raising a family here. When Sunset Drive transformed into a pedestrian destination, it fueled private investment and commercial activity. It's a great place to live.
The downtown South Miami area is composed of parts of the city of South Miami, Coral Gables, and Miami-Dade County. The hometown plan focused on a core area around Dorn Avenue, Sunset Drive, and the Metro Rail Station. In 1992, there were buildings that contributed to the urban fabric which the plan recommended keeping. In the future, South Miami will have a more complete urban fabric with infill buildings, pedestrian-friendly streets, and open spaces.
More than 20 new restaurants have opened since I moved here in 1997. Many of the people working in the area get to lunch every day on Sunset Drive. South Miami is where I work, and it's also home to several major employers like Baptist Health South Florida, Larkin Hospital, South Miami Hospital, and the International Studies Preparatory Academy. On my commute, I burn calories, not oil. With a short walk, I can go to the grocery store, dine out, go to the park, or see a movie.
I've worked in South Miami for 7 years. I park in a parking garage every day. Properly designed parking garages are essential. The hometown plan envisions several mid-block parking garages screened by liner buildings to accommodate the parking needs for the surrounding area, alleviating each individual business from having to provide their own separate parking. Dover Kohl and Partners assisted the city and the not-for-profit organization South Miami Hometown Inc. with promoting redevelopment of the area, preparing a work plan, conducting a charrette to design a detailed master plan, and rewriting the land development regulations. The refrain from participants heard again and again was, "We want our Main Street back." Long after the completion of the charrette, the educational value is apparent through active community support and investment in plan implementation.
I'm able to take transit every day from Brickell, the center of Miami. The South Miami Metrorail station opened in 1984, but it wasn't until South Miami was itself a destination that the station has become fully utilized. The hometown plan is a showcase of planning principles thoughtfully implemented.
When I visit our hometown on a weekend night, I ask other diners where they're from and why they came here. Their answer is always the same. We live in the south part of the county and we drive north until we get to the first lovely place where we can park once and spend the evening walking and dining. That answer is music to a mayor's ears. We in South Miami embrace the gracious planning and design of our hometown district, and we want to continue farther on this path.
South Miami is slowly becoming a nighttime destination for people from all over the city. I'm a new arrival. I live 5 minutes from work and I never have to drive my car. This is a fun place. And it's a 24-hour place.
I see no limit to how wonderful South Miami can become for our residents and visitors by putting people and quality of life in the center of our planning process.